I'm Nancy J with the Celebrity Spotlight on Rock Music's 2012 Revivalist and Ambassador. Now, that's how those in the know describe musician James Durbin. Does he look familiar? Mm-hmm. It was only a year ago that we were all watching James on American Idol and voting for him. He placed fourth, and he has not stopped since. In fact, he's got his debut record out, Memories of a Beautiful Disaster, and he's with us to bring back rock and roll. So what that means is, though, rock and roll went away?
I think rock and roll is, I think it's starting to come back. I think people are finally getting back in that mindset. You know, everybody just wants to have a good time, and whatever kind of music it is that people are into these days, it's all about having a good time. So that's what I look for in rock music. My favorite era of rock is the 80s, definitely.
Ah, okay.
Heavily influenced by 80s hair metal and all the great stuff like that.
And that was what was so fun about you on American Idol. You brought rock and heavy metal to that stage. And I know that in a lot of ways, this has changed your life. Completely. I mean, you were working at a pizza place and they went bankrupt, but they weren't gonna let you go audition. But fortunately, they closed shop, so you got to go audition, right?
Yeah, fortunately, it turned out that a curse turned into a blessing.
Well, in many ways, maybe that's what this title means, right?
Yeah, the title, Memories of a Beautiful Disaster, it's about looking back at moments of my life that at one point I thought were a curse, and they turned out to be a blessing because they make me who I am today. And why would I ever want to change that? You learn from your mistakes, and what you've done in the past is what makes you who you are.
Well said. Absolutely well said. And of course, we've got your first single on this is Love Me Bad.
Mm-hmm.
But it's pop and it's rock. I mean, it's been on all the different genres of radio stations.
It's nice to have something that can be construed to all different areas. And it was a lot of fun to make the music video you see behind us.
Right.
We shot that all in one day.
Cigarette fills an empty room. Smell of heartbreaks and cheap perfume. Photos scattered across my wall. Maybe someday I'll take them off, but I miss you.
Let's talk about the record then.
Certainly
in terms of, besides Love Me Bad being the first single, I do like the song Stand Up too, because I think I'm hearing that, what, with some sports connections, is the NFL and...
Yes, I was approached by the NFL coming directly off of American Idol. And they approached me and said, we're interested in working with you. We have this song that we'd like you to sing for a Game Day soundtrack. It ended up being on the Game Day Volume 2 soundtrack. Which is like by the fans, for the fans sort of thing. And they play it in all the stadiums. I shot a couple 32 videos for each team for the NFL. And those videos play in the stadiums, and then they play the song in the stadium. And it's just a really fun song. I heard the song and couldn't put it down. I kept having to listen to it and tweaked it and made it my own from the original demo. And it's a real fun one to sing. It kicks off all of our shows, so it's we're very happy to have it.
But are you looking ahead? Are you just going to try to get through this new year with your tour? And you know, where do you go from here?
I've been to the lowest I can possibly get, so for me, there's nowhere to go but up. You know, there's always going to be hills to climb and mountains to climb, but. It's a long way to the top if you want to rock and roll. I recently had the pleasure and the privilege of meeting Nikki Sixx from Motley Crue, And Mick Mars played on my record on the song Outcast. But I finally got to meet Nikki Sixx, and he was telling me that at this stage of Motley Crue and them coming up, they were playing in delis. And I talked to Evanescence, and they said that they were playing in roller rinks. You know, so it's I have a lot to be thankful for.
You've done very, very well. You're on the road. You're doing it, and I wish you the best, James.
Thank you so much.
It's really nice to meet you in person.
Thank you.
So just keep up the good work, and of course we want you to look for memories of a beautiful disaster in your power zone.